Hey there, this is Christoph Schwarz from Qlik with a Tuesday Tips video. This time I picked a funny topic. I want to have a floor plan, something like this, to be used without an extension. An object where I can visualize some data, where I can pan, zoom, and which interacts, of course, with the data model. To get to this, I'll explain the approach. Then we will generate some tiles from our source image, in my case, the yacht, using magic and an Excel form. And then we will create some point position data and project them onto the GeoObject. And then we will configure this QlikSense GeoObject together. So the approach is the following. Assuming I have an image, which I want to use via the GeoObject, I have to actually pretend and convert this image into a map server. Something usually, I've given an example here below, where the GeoObject contacts a tile service, which delivers the background map piece by piece. So what the GeoObject automatically generates for you is, depending where you are, what you're zooming in, it calculates the zoom factor, the X and the Y position, and requests the respective tile through that URL. Now, having the yacht to produce the zoom level 0 is still easy because it's just all on one tile, but the resolution is pretty bad. It's only 256 times 256 pixels. So the next level, zoom level 1, covers an area of a total size of 512 pixels, and it's 4 images like this. Then zoom level 2 is even twice as big, but it already has 16 tiles, and the naming would be something like yacht and set 2 and all the different combinations of X and Y. And zoom level 3, which I think is a good compromise because it covers a total size of 2048 times 2048 pixels, but we need to slice our original image into 64 tiles with a naming convention like this. Of course, you don't want to create all those tiles by hand, do you? So we need some magic here. I found a very cool command line tool from imagemagic.org. The download link is given here, and it also ships a portable version. Just extract the zip file into one particular place. In my case, it's CE portable apps and into a folder, and that's enough. Right, that tool will help me to slice the objects, but how do I create all the 85 different command line combinations that it takes? For that purpose, I've prepared an Excel, which actually only takes two settings from you. It's the exact location and path of the source image, in my case, the yacht. So this path I will need, and the yacht.png I specify as the input file, and the position or the place of your magic k.exe. That's it. The rest can be found here on the conversion page. There are a couple of parameters now calculated, which gets you the right slice. So as I said earlier, on zoom level 0, we will have one file created with that name. On zoom level 1, it's going to be 4 files. It's going to be 16 files for the next, and so on. But you don't need to understand all of this. It's sufficient just to copy the column E to the clipboard, open up a DOS prompt, and then you paste it. That means line by line, these Excel created commands will be executed, and what's happening now in the source folder of your image is that it creates all those tiles. So level 0 is completed, 1 is completed, 2 is completed, 3 it's still working on, it takes about a minute, and then you have all those 85 tiles. So once it's done, we will copy all those images created into a place where you can access it using HTTP or HTTPS, because we will tell the GeoObject later to use that as a web service. In ClickSense Desktop and in ClickSense Server, you can use the so-called content libraries. Everything you place there has automatically HTTP or HTTP address. In my case, I will now move all those files from the folder, except for the yacht. I will move it into the folder given here, which is your Qlik Sense content default folder. So now it's there, and we can go to the next step. And this is actually getting the positions of the sensors or whatever you want to visualize here. So the easiest way to do so is to think of absolute pixel positions. I'm using a tool called Irfan View, which as soon as I Qlik and make a selection tells me that selection. So for example, that table here has got 354 and 206 in X and Y dimensions. And that sofa has got this selection. So just note them down and build a very basic table like the following. So here I have absolute positions of X and Y, including some artificial ones just for curiosity, to have the extreme positions like top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right, and also the center. So what is now missing is to project this onto a map. The map actually has a hardwired maximum and minimum longitude and latitude, which comes from the fact that the Earth spans approximately that many meters around the equator and from north to south pole. Those are the dimensions that I need my data to be projected on. So given your X and Y, I will use the following formula to convert this into the given lat and long. So when I add this to the script, the width and height and also those two functions, and run the script, then we have all we need to start configuring the GeoObject. Well, the GeoObject will have two or three layers, a point layer and a background layer, which uses our own images. And then optionally also an invisible area layer that helps to avoid auto-zooming into some corners of the map. So let's get the GeoObject set up from scratch. So we will not use any of the base maps. So we put this to none. The projection must be meters. That's very important. It's not a degree projection, it's meters. We actually will not need the legend. And in the presentation layer, we will limit the zoom level to use maximum of 3x zoom. That's the number of slippy layer tiles that we have prepared, and we don't want these kilometers here to show. So that's the basic setting as a starting point, and then we add the background layer. And the URL now here will be the localhost and so on, including this X, Z, and Y PNG. So instantly this shows, and it can already be moved and zoomed, but it doesn't have data yet, of course. So the next thing is we will go back to the layer settings and add the point layer. So as a point dimension, we will pick whatever the point dimension is. In my case, it's called point. And now we need to use as the location setting, latitude and longitude fields. And we will use the formula from the code snippet that I just created in the script before. We go on the formula editor, will be fx to long. So this converts the X position to a longitude, and it needs two more arguments, the width and the height of the picture, which comes from a variable, whereas X is coming from a field in the data model. So copy this to the clipboard, since the next formula is going to be very similar. And we have Y to lat as the other formula. And this has the other two arguments. Yeah, and it needs the Y field. We can now use it as you usually can use any other geographic data and assign, for example, some values. So I use this in the point layer to define the size, for example, everything as you would usually do with a normal map. Mouse over works, selections will work, zooming, panning, everything. The only thing that I personally don't like now is the fact that if I click home, I'm actually taken into some part of the picture that still covers all my points, but I would find it more natural if home always shows me the full map. I have to use a trick here. The trick is to add an invisible diagonal from the northwest end to the southeast end and use this as a separate layer. Again, here's a script snippet that you just copy paste into your load script. I've done this already a little bit further down here. So I can use this formula, which just takes width and height, nothing else. And this will hopefully plot a diagonal all the time. So it's an area layer. It does not need a dimension, but I have to specify one here. So it can be any constant, like a text or a number. And in the location where it has a expected location field, there we go with this formula, F full area, and we again give the width and the height. And this plots this diagonal. We don't want to see this diagonal, so the easiest way is just to move the area layer down so that the background is on top of it, so we don't see it. And now, even if we make selections and have only this free, and still if I pan around and click on home, it will adjust also to the invisible diagonal. So it is a different behavior when using the home button. So with that, we've done everything I promised and use a custom floor plan as a native object in QlikSense. Have fun and stay tuned with the Tuesday tips.